You kids are so judgmental.
Power tee.
Hey, Roger.
Hey, glad you're here. So I know these are all power ties, but which one of these says I will crush you in a hostile takeover?
Burgundy.
She's right.
I can't believe this is a conversation. Come on, I'm going to be late for work. Time is money, slacker. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
I'm embarrassed to be seen with you.
I'm embarrassed to be seen with you. What happened to you?
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 Best friends?
Best friends.
By making a change in your destiny, affirmation, I deserve success.
I deserve success.
Personal power and growth are tools.
Personal
in my
power
arsenal.
And growth are tools.
Ah, please, God, no more!
Hey,
Mike.
Deserve a large automobile. I deserve a beautiful wife with beautiful breasts.
How did I get here? And the days go by.
Mourning the baby that she couldn't have, and the baby that she almost got to adopt.
Katie, it's dynasty shots. You only do a shot when someone gets slapped.
I know. I was thirsty.
You miserable bitch.
Wait for it.
Now.
Oh, man. Dynasty represents everything that is good, pure, and true about America.
I agree. Guys, do you think I need shoulder pads? Sophia stopped by today.
Oh, they're in the fountain. It's wetter and better. I saw ass. Is so hot. Oh my God, where did this happen? Were you guys in the shower? She kissed you?
It was just a kiss. Nothing happened. Besides the kiss.
Did you struggle at first, knowing it was forbidden? Then tongues, right? If she's got the hots for you and all you do is make candles, I must really be a loser. You're not a loser. You're more of a non-winner. Yeah, well, RT offered me a job today. And you took it, right? I just don't know if I'd be very good at it.
It's marketing. You write slogans, which is like writing lyrics, except it's easier because they don't have to rhyme. Oh, where's the beef?
You know what? I am tired of being broke. Hell, I'm doing it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Welcome to Reagan's America. God bless you, Ronnie.
Okay, no more for you.
Man, that was the first day. Tell me all about it.
Well, I found my parking spot, met a couple of really nice people, and within 4 hours, I was about ready to kill myself. What was I thinking?
Help! Hey, let's regroup. Focus on the chicks you're gonna get with that money. You don't even need a good pickup line.
Look, there's Sophia. Turn away, she doesn't see us.
Sophia! Over here! Hi, Sophia. You know what? I think it's time I come clean with you.
I go both ways, too. I understand your needs.
Ew!
Do you need to think about it?
Unfortunately, yes.
Well, good for her. She's the kind of person who needs a steady relationship. Me, I like playing the field.
Ah, good for you, bro. A steady chick in holidays equal nothing but cash.
And I ain't about that, bro.
Bro?
It's a new thing I'm trying out. Besides, if you wait until the end of Valentine's Day, any girl who doesn't have someone comes running after you, my man.
Bro.
Thanks. I don't want to alarm anyone, but there's a sailor in the backyard.
Owen?
Amy, happy Valentine's Day.
Wow, Owen, I wasn't expecting to see you.
Roger.
Bro?
Hey, Owen, maybe later we can go down to the arcade like old times, huh? Did you know Pac-Man got married?
I really missed you.
So someone gave Tuesday candy? Who do you think it was, bro?
Still doing that bro thing?
Just working out the kinks. Thinking about adding a gesture.
Hey, maybe she sent it to herself to see how I'd react. Why am I even talking about this? Forget I said anything.
Oh, hold on. Let's think this through. Sometimes the ladies get desperate, and they make the first move. And that's when you become the hunted. And that, my bro, is the sweetest scenario.
Are you wearing mascara?
A little bit. All I'm saying is that you have hit the jackpot.
What would I do without you, bro? Owen, man, good to see you.
Corey.
No, this is Owen, Katie's boyfriend.
Boyfriend? I don't understand.
You know, boyfriend, you've had some. The girls you sleep with have had some.
Okay, let's roll.
Your kids going out to have some fun, huh? Your kids. You darn kids. God bless you. Well, go on out there and have the time of your life.
Nobody minds.
Katie. Nobody minds.
Do you mind?
No, sir. They've been dating on and off since high school. I don't know how serious it is.
This is such a betrayal. I mean, she can keep a man from me, and she's keeping a woman from me, too.
Except that you're the only one who's bisexual.
So far.
Well, well, well. Sobbing brunette in the corner. Oh, my. Okay, on the count of three, we can dance away together. One.
Hey!
So I'm trying to comfort this hot, wounded brunette, and Archie swoops in with a sea breeze and a hanky.
Smooth bastard.
Claire! Oh, this is great! We can leave! He found someone!
Oh, boy, did I strike out tonight.
Where did you run off to?
Maybe I should enlist. You guys in the Navy score a lot, don't you, bro?
Not lately, bro.
Honey, how would you like to make your old man one of your delicious frittatas?
Okay.
Okay, Roger, are you in?
I don't like eggs. Can I have a turkey sandwich instead?
Ooh, I want that, but grill mine?
Hey, fellas, fellas, you know what's on. Aerobicize AM.
With Donna Haley?
That's right, let's go!
It's okay, Owen, go ahead.
Like this?
Nope.
Like this?
Stop it.
All right. Everyone, listen up. I'm over it. You, with the hat, back to your apartment. You, on the sofa, stop feeling sorry for yourself. Corey, why do you have to have everything grilled?
Katie, have you got a couple minutes?
Yes.
Do Do you consider yourself to be someone who knows a good value?
Yes.
And if you could save some money, you'd like that, wouldn't you?
Why, yes.
And if I said you could be driving a brand new car with no money down, you'd be interested, right?
Yes.
Congratulations, you just bought a brand new car.
I see what you did. That was very convincing.
Thank you.
What color is it? What color is my brand new car?
Doesn't matter. It's a done deal.
It is not. I want to see the manager.
Bam! I get that all the time.
Okay, okay. Easy now, car boy.
Look, I'll make my 15 sale by the end of the day. They'll take my demo away. My demo's a BMW. I worship my BMW.
Oh, now, come on. You shouldn't worship a car, son. You need to worship something truly valuable. Like money. I hear the tiger, Roger.
Thanks for the pep talk, RT.
In Katie's room.
You know, if I were you, I'd be really careful, because Sophia doesn't do a lot of giving without a lot of taking.
Oh, that's sweet. You've given me advice. Don't do that.
And if I said you could drive off the lot today with absolutely no money down, you'd be interested, right?
Yes.
Congratulations. I'll get the keys.
Hold on. Okay. I'm just afraid that's more than we were planning on spending.
Understandable. For a car without floor mats. But what if I was able to fill them in for no extra charge? Do you like free?
Sure.
Okay, you two sit tight and think about that first romantic drive you're going to take up that coast together, huh? And I'm going to try to talk my boss into this deal.
You got them in that brown diesel? With a mock leather interior? No way.
Yes, way.
That piece of high gross crap? No way.
Way?
We're going to take some time and think about it and come back later.
Wait, I was just coming back in. I got you the mats. All four. Freshly vacuumed, pine scented, and everything.
We'll let you know, dear.
Okay, then, I'll be right here waiting.
Was that Mr. and Mrs. B back? Because you know they won't.
Night.
Where are you going? We still have 15 minutes.
Oh, come on, give it up, Rod. They're not coming.
I hate the elderly, those lying sons of bitches.
Look, you may be losing the Beamer, but maybe they'll let you drive a trade-in. You know, that yellow one's not bad. As long as you don't have to go in reverse.
Yeah, rotten hell, Frank. Oh, sorry I let you down, little buddy.
Mr. Park, we've decided to buy the car.
Come in, have a seat. I don't want to pressure you. I mean, I could give you more time. Say 7 minutes.
We're sure.
Oh, great. I can't tell you how much this sale means to me. A deal like this won't come along twice.
You're right. This will probably be the last car we ever buy.
It's expensive, but we can cash out the life insurance.
And I really should switch to generic blood pressure medicine. After all, we do need a reliable car to drive you to dialysis, Papa.
Could you excuse me just a sec?
And he scores with the Hail Mary in the fourth. Way to go, dude.
They can't afford this car.
Yeah, but they're going to buy it, right?
I can't do this to these people. I hear they need a reliable car, and I'm selling them some overpriced death trap. I know what I've got to do. You do the closing.
Split the commission.
80-20.
60-40.
Done. Boy, am I going to sleep better tonight.
The seat's taken. I got a good feeling about tonight. Yeah, that stool's about to grab some ass.
You feeling lucky tonight, Roger?
Oh, yeah. Chicks love the smell of success. And Roger stinks of it.
Why do we always have to go to Sophia's club?
It's not her club, it's our club.
You have to get over her and get back on the horse.
Speaking of horses, you remember that girl you picked up here last month?
Shut up.
What's her name?
have zebra pants.
I can put you on my conference. I might get you in a VIP room.
There's a VIP room?
No. I'll get you in. Can I bring my brother? He's right here.
This is a dance club, not a sit and question life club.
You know, someday everybody's going to hear my music. What did I ever see in Sophia? Well, okay, she's beautiful.
It's sad. You'll never get a girl like her again.
You gotta let it go, man. Remember when we went out for track and we didn't make it?
I remember I made it and you didn't.
And we got over that.
Okay, let's talk more of today's great hits.
I want to pay rent for the apartment above the garage. Depressed mode out there has to shut up.
You know, I might be crazy, but it sounds like you're sassing me.
I'm sorry, but I live a full life. I party way too hard not to get my 4 hours of primo sleep. Plus, my sales suck and my boss wants to see me today. I'm a little tense.
Now, don't be shy around your boss. A kid from the loading dock barges into my office with an idea. Now, I sell everything in two words. Gut whacker. Butt worker. So he says, make it one word. Gut whacker. Butt worker.
Crazy kid. Oh, man, I totally nailed this song. I mean, I really hit it out of the park. I was up all night with it.
Yeah, we all were.
Well, it's not really that kind of song. It's not the kind of song for people to hear. What is it, for dogs?
Well, nobody's tapping that market.
What about Sophia? No, I told you I'm over her. No, we didn't go out. We just had coffee.
Oh, what?
You're in. What exactly did you say? Well, I said, do you want to go get coffee? And she said she was going to get coffee anyway, so whatever. What? You say coffee? And she says whatever? Meaning, whatever? You're a musician. She likes music. You're older. Whatever. You're in. No, please. It was just coffee. So, boss, I guess I feel I speak for both of us when I say we have the same concern, which is, are we doing enough to help Roger sell cars? And Roger doesn't think so. You know, there's no you in failure.
Yes, there is.
Okay, well, at any rate, what do we do? I know you're stumped, but let me put it to you in one sweet word. Ready? Car dealership. See? One word.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay. You know how we're Zales Pontiac Mazda?
Yeah.
Listen to this. Zales Pontiac Mazda. Rolls right off the tongue. Zales Pontiac Mazda. People say, wait a minute. What's that about?
You're fired, Roger.
What?
You're fired, Roger.
No, I'm just a crazy kid with a good idea.
You're fired, Roger.
Oh, okay, maybe I didn't explain this right.
One word.
You're fired, Roger. Okay, okay. Posse, posse. What? Didn't you just lose your job? This is an opportunity, not an anti-fortunity. That's not a word. I just said it, so it's a word. Now, come on, let's go. These pants look great, but they're riding up on me already.
Can I have a gin and something pink, please? Roger? Are you okay?
Never better! Hey, it's a jungle in here.
Three more?
really think doing all those shots is gonna make you forget you got fired?
I got fired?
Take Mr. Zebra Pants home.
Morning. Aren't you late for work?
What work? Your advice got me fired.
What advice?
The crazy kid from the loading dock. Butt whacker, gut worker.
Oh, him. Yeah, I fired the mouthy son of a bitch.
Why didn't you tell me that?
Why didn't you ask?
Okay, because in my music, I have never written the lyrics... Or the beat ka-chung, ka-chung, and I would never add a ooh,
Sorry, if I sit still, feelings come up.
Tuesday! Something and something Tuesday!
Shut up! It's 4 in the morning, for God's sakes! Shut up!
Tuesday! 4 in the morning, Tuesday! For God's sake, shut up!
No, that's...
'Cause you sing in German.
Hey, I got the Luftballons on that one over there.
Hey, another round for my friend, sir, and hit me again with that great big stick I like to call Mr. Scotch.
Come on, Rick. You're gonna have to get these, man.
No, I'm celebrating. Come on, beautiful, let's dance.
No, thanks, Rick. No one can keep up with you. Not even the music.
Hey, come in. Hey, I was stopped by your lot today. Think it's time for a new ride. What are you selling these days?
A high-end import.
Roger, you sell Yugo.
Listen, I got a cousin with a Chrysler dealership in Chula Vista. I'll hook you up.
Minivans, my man. I'm on that like a rash.
I'll be back.
Silver Pants was gonna get this round.
I still can't believe it.
Neither can I.
How can he be dead?
Dude, his heart just stopped.
But he was doing so well financially.
I could have saved his life if only I danced with him. I'm a really slow dancer.
Katie, believe me, dancing didn't kill him.
No, no.
There's a line you don't want to cross when you party, and Rick snorted his.
I guess the paramedics did everything they could.
They were terrific. Oh, did you see that lady paramedic? What is it about a woman in uniform that makes me want to bark?
Roger, our friend just died. Oh, my God. I just called Rick our friend, but do you know something? I didn't even know his last name.
Me neither. I just always called him Silver Pants.
We have so many friends like that. There's Crazy Girl.
And Slow Eddie. Oh, what about the poker? Did you hear he got engaged to Nose Job Bad Perm?
Hey!
Wow! You guys, I was the last person Rick spoke to.
Oh, you were?
Did he say anything about where I could hook up with his cousin, the car dealer?
You know, the one that has a job for me?
Well, 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 you beat me home. That's the first.
Daddy, a guy we knew died at the club tonight.
Really? How?
He was living in the fast lane.
Yeah, but what killed him?
One minute he was dancing, and the next minute he was dead.
Listen, kids, I know this is hard for you. You're young. This kind of thing isn't supposed to happen. But obviously this guy had a terminal illness.
I promise I won't move. I'll stay right here, quiet as a mouse.
Oh, my God! I thought you were dead. Sophia, that's Roger. Then who's Rick?
Silver Pants?
Hey! I liked him!
Thank you.
Anyway, Katie. Okay, well, this is gonna make you feel real bad. I made a little bet and I won.
You kicked some commander's butt at golf?
Just a few of my better friends, and I would love for you and Owen to stop by. It's good to see you happy.
What was that all about, my dove?
It's really very simple, Roger. If I can't get the lady to want me, then I'll get the lady's man to want the lady to want me.
A menage a trois. What man could resist?
Katie and Owen will soon become Katie, Owen, and Sophia.
Such a simple plan, and yet so powerful.
But you haven't heard the pièce de résistance.
Wait, the what?
The best part? When Owen ships out, who do you think Katie will be left with?
You, of course. That's genius. Sophia, you are delicious.
Let's just hope they think so. Bad feelings replaced with porcelain.
Let me get this straight. Old man Silverpants comes into the store and wants you to give the eulogy. And you let him walk right out without asking him about the cousin with the dealership in Chula Vista. You selfish bastard. Believe me, I had other things to think about, like what am I going to say about a complete stranger?
You know, son, the secret to selling is knowing your product.
What the hell are you talking about?
Damn it, son, focus. Now go back to the club. Do some research. For God's sake, find out what really killed him.
Is he just stupid, or is this classic denial?
I'm not talking to you.
Gonna miss him. Are you a relative?
A cousin.
Really? Sorry, man. Do you have a car dealership?
No.
Is that cousin here?
So what are you guys gonna do with the apartment above the garage now that he's dead?
Sophia, I live above the garage. I'm alive, damn it, I'm alive.
Do you have a car dealership in Chula Vista?
Shh! Does anyone have a car dealership in Chula Vista?
Hey, did you know people call me One Beer?
Yeah, I started that.
Thanks a lot, car man.
Hey, what do people call me? That only happened once.
A lot of people saw.
Hey. Here comes Like Some Young.
Like Some Young?
Hey, kids, how's it going?
How can you be $1,000 in debt?
I don't know. I paid my minimum balance every month.
Don't you realize you're paying interest on the interest? That's how they make their money.
It's not nice.
But it's business, making money off the unsuspecting. Damn, I wish I had a piece of that action. I'll get it.
Don't answer it! Don't answer it! Roger, this is our house. I answer the phone.
So, are you gonna answer it?
No, I'm going to let the machine pick it up.
This is a message for Katie Howard. Please call Karen at Visa regarding an urgent matter. Thank you.
Why does Karen keep calling me?
Why are you whispering? She can't hear you.
That's right, she can't. I'm being paranoid.
That blue van's been out there a long time.
Katie, just ask Dad for the money. Explain what happened.
I can't do that. Daddy trusts me, and that means the world to me. And I'm not going to jeopardize that with the truth. What if I tell Dad that I want to go on spring break, and then I use the money that he gives me to pay off my credit cards?
Didn't you drop out of school last quarter?
Yeah. It's the part that's bothering me.
Why? You never even told him you dropped out.
So you're saying this could work?
Of course. I mean, what's another layer of lies and deceit among family?
For your information, I have every intention of paying off my credit cards and returning to school. And besides, I'll only do this one time, and I'll never use my credit card again, unless it's an emergency, like a sale at Casual Corner.
So wait, when Dad sees you here on spring break, you'll say, Buenos dias, Papa. Estoy en Cancun.
No, because I won't be here. I'll be upstairs at Roger's.
Hey. You keep a checkbook in your bathroom?
Sometimes you have to buy stuff in the bedroom, son.
You're my idol.
I really appreciate you letting me stay here. You're not charging me, are you?
No. Make yourself comfortable.
Is that a new couch?
I just got it today. The old one wasn't working with my parachute pants. Every time I sat down, I'd slip off and end up on the floor. Damn. It wasn't the couch.
What is that big piece of wood for?
Oh, it's my dance square. It's where I practice my moves. Hey, hit the light. You're the first one to see that.
That's cool.
You want to see it with the jacket?
No, I'm good. I came as soon as I heard. Are you okay? Why? What did you hear? You're staying with Roger for a week. You should stay with me. Roger, who did you tell?
Just Troy, the bartender.
And Troy's cousin lives with my tanning coach. Oh, you have a dance square? You guys, this is serious. Have either of you ever been to Cancun? Because I need details.
I have, and I had an absolutely fantastic time. I don't remember any of it.
Hey, Roger, are you up there?
It's my dad.
Quick, get in my closet. It kind of smells like Mexico.
Take your time.
What's up?
Hey, Roger. You have any smokes?
You don't smoke.
That's because Katie doesn't let me. But now that she's gone, I'm just thinking of taking it up again. Chip, they're barbecued. The women don't let you eat these.
Well, the women won't let you wear pants either?
Nah. I figure while Katie's away, we'll either dress or not dress, however we feel. Are you in?
No.
You're lost. Oh, hey, there's the paper boy. I'm going to go bum a smoke off of him.
He's 11.
You're right. Kids don't share. Stingy little son of a bitch. Here, hold my chips. I'm going to go kick his ass.
Okay, I'm off to work. What's this?
A glass?
Exactly. Only plastic tumblers leave the kitchenette. Suppose the glass shatters on the dance square. Roger cuts himself, then what happens?
Roger can't spread the magic.
Thank you. Oh, and another thing. The tape line in the closet, you're over it by two hangers. What happened to your head?
I slipped out of a Buick at work.
Raj, for safety reasons, don't you think you should give up the parachute pants?
Can't do it. Sometimes you have to take the good with the bad.
Yeah, yeah, but what's the good?
and upset.
What do you care if I starve?
Archie, are you all right?
No. I just smoked 3 packs of cigarettes, I ate all the ice cream, and I got sucker punched by an 11-year-old kid. Freedom is killing me.
You miss Katie, don't you?
She is the glue, son. She is the glue.
Archie, can I tell you something?
Sure.
Close your robe. I can see your Hall & Oates.
If you can't stand the heat, get out of the kitchen.
Now I remember what I did in Mexico. I blacked out.
Hey, look. I love a wicker chair. It grabs and holds.
You know anything about Bananarama? Are you getting any of this? Looking good. Now toss your hat back.
Open your gloves a little so it looks more real.
Now put your hands over your head like you're having a good time.
Okay, now drink and have sex with a close friend and worry about the ramifications later.
Oh, pick me? Pick me? It's not gonna be anyone. I know how those spring break flings end up.
All right, fine. Maybe I'll pick up on that cute waiter with the mustache.
Picking up a guy? I thought you were into women.
Roger, I'm bi. And bye.
Oh, no, you're getting weepy drunk.
You know something, Roger? When this vacation is over, I'm going to straighten out my life. Pay off my debt, go back to school, and get a degree in ethics, damn it. Now walk me back to America. I want to go home.
Oh, Katie, I just brought your bags in from the cab.
Roger, stop your lying. Time to straighten out your life. I'm going upstairs. It's going to be so good to be in my own bed. I spent last night in Roger's.
Gotta go.
Hold it right there, Roger. Honey, you go on up in your room and turn the music up real loud.
Okay.
Listen, Archie, nothing happened. And she has no respect for glassware.
Sit down. Hell, you got your own problems.
Really, Sophia, you know, these kind of bright, showy birthday parties only work on children.
Ooh, a champagne fountain.
That's it? Thank you? No tears of joy, no lingering hug?
Look, it's early. She'll come around. Maybe she didn't notice the seafood buffet.
This constant rejection is really wearing on me. I turned down work to plan this party. What am I doing? My God. Did I just open up to you?
Man, you have hit rock bottom.
I have a good mind not to pop out of the cake.
I need your help. My look isn't working tonight, man. Give me your car keys. I gotta go change my jacket.
Take it off.
Wear half an outfit? Man, I'm all about the outfit. People expect it from me. Roger, once you start moving, people aren't gonna care what you're wearing. Hey, who's the mayor of Funky Town?
I am?
Yeah.
Thanks, Corey. What was I thinking?
It's Owen!
Katie.
Hey, Roger. What do you think of my new toy?
Man, can't wait to be rich enough to call expensive things toys.
Yeah, it's a goal worth working for, all right. Women love the expensive toys, Roger.
Damn, you could start a church. Hey, Owen, I have to use the bathroom.
I got you, buddy.
Hurry up, sailor. I've had a couple of beers. You filming this?
I have no idea.
Man, this really hurts. I hope it doesn't affect my dancing.
Hey, Roger, I think there's a lot more important things in the world than your dancing.
Take it back. Take it back right now. Yo, I don't carry cash.
Roger, this is Tuesday.
Oh, so you're Tuesday. So, Tuesday, sit down. I want to hear all about...
You said party. This is not a party. This is a family gathering. I may as well be here for Thanksgiving. If your sister weren't so damn nice, I would skin you and wear you like a hat.
Wow, she's scary hot.
Yeah, I know.
Man, you are so lucky.
Well, it's not completely luck.
Oh, man. When a woman is that wild, she's looking for one thing, to be tamed.
Trust me, I know what I'm doing.
I'm so sick of wasting top shelf Roger on you. You know what? Fine. You just sit here and figure it out on your own. If you see me getting smaller, it's because Roger's leaving. I am out of here. It doesn't really work as well when you can't actually get up and walk out.
Oh, my, thank you, Margaret, for bringing these over. I completely spaced on Katie's gift. You really saved my ass.
Yeah, yeah. People always take advantage of you when you have a van.
It's a certificate for 4 full body massages by Roger of San Diego.
Did I write full body? I meant foot... body.
I'm not carrying you to the bathroom anymore.
I am not your girlfriend. Scary hot.
Who needs a beer?
I believe in crystal light, cause I believe in me.
Hey, ooh. I believe in me. Roger! It's your bet!
Oh, yeah. I'm in. I'll raise a 20.
I'm in.
I'm in. So, what do you have?
Nothing. Why don't you guys fold? My poker face is perfect.
Because you sing the Crystal Light theme music when you're bluffing?
I do not. I do.
All right, let's take a little break. I gotta go drain some lager.
Good evening, Mr. Bond.
Hey, where's Tuesday?
She walked out.
What happened?
We kissed.
In the kitchen?
Did you do it on the table?
No.
Counter, right?
Height advantage?
No. We just kissed. Why would a girl kiss you and then just take off?
Oh, man, that happens to me all the time. See, women, they, well, the thing about women is... Okay, we're talking about women, right?
Yeah, women.
What are you guys doing?
Talking about women.
You want to know about women? Well, you're talking to a man who just proposed to one, and you know what? Women. No, they are. Okay, she. This cake is good.
It's really good cake.
It's good.
Talking about women, huh? Well, I'm tapped out.
Play for that job you offered Katie.
Ooh, I want in on that action.
All right, big shots, you're on. Whoever wins this hand gets the job.
Okay, bluff time. Focus. Don't sing. You don't believe in Crystal Light, and it doesn't believe in you. You can't do this.
Roger?
I'll see you. And I'll raise your 40.
I'm out.
I fold.
Really?
I was bluffing. I won!
Well done, Roger. Sophia, when can you start?
RT, I won.
Look, son, I said whoever won the hand would get the job because I assumed Sophia would win, so she gets the job.
Well, what does Roger get?
Oh, Roger gets something much better than a job. Today, Roger learned two valuable lessons. One, how to bluff, and two, that life's unfair.
I'll get these.
Someone's in a good mood.
Have I mentioned lately that I love my job?
I'm guessing this has something to do with Tuesday.
Yep. You know, work is a lot better when you're not actually doing work.
Well, what are you doing?
Oh, I don't kiss and tell.
You just did.
Corey, I think you and Tuesday together are so sweet. I mean, once you get past your spikes, chains, and cynicism, she's like a tiny, fuzzy badger baby.
Man, I wish somebody at my car dealership was hot. Terry in parts is cute, but she's got a deeper voice than me and enormous hands.
You know, Terry can also be a man's name.
That explains the Adam's apple.
You've made that mistake before.
When?
You had a crush on our high school guidance counselor.
Katie, our guidance counselor was a woman.
Old man Benson was a woman?
Hi, Katie, Corey. I'm using Sidekick.
Hi, Sophia. Hey, aren't you going to start working for my dad tomorrow?
That's right. You're looking at the new director of marketing.
Oh. Do you have any actual marketing experience?
I made a killing in the stock market. I have fantastic organizational skills. Let's not forget animal print night.
That was great.
And as far as being able to set trends, I was cutting my sweatshirts months before Flashdance.
Mmm. Fuzzy navel. How about I freshen it up for you? You want more fuzz or more navel?
Venus?
Hey, Katie.
What are you doing here?
I work here. I was bartending down at the Pink Panther, but they went out of business.
That closed down. Our dirty eyes.
Roger, this is Venus, my aerobics instructor. I tell people about you all the time. You teach the best class.
Oh, yeah, I know. And you, Katie, are my star pupil.
Venus is a professional dancer.
Oh, I had a few small gigs. I was in the Thriller video. I was third zombie from the right.
Oh, yeah!
I didn't recognize you with all your flesh.
There's my kvassia drinker. I might not be back.
You should take her class, Roger.
I don't want to get too ripped. Besides, aerobics? It's for girls.
Yeah, you're right. You'd be the only guy. Is that three?
Okay, everybody, are you ready to show your body who's boss? Hey, Katie. I see you brought your little friend Robert.
Roger.
Oh, whatever, honey. Just find a spot and get ready to surrender to the mighty Venus. All right, deep breath in and heel hops. And 5, 6, 7, 8. Better get in shape or get ready to die.
please shut your dog up? We're trying to relax over here.
You shut up!
Marquis, you've got to try aerobics. It really works. I got 5 phone numbers, only 3 of them are fake.
Aerobics is a load of crap, Roger. You need a bunch of expensive exercise equipment that you buy off the television to get in shape. And that's the only way.
I'm never going to aerobics class again.
Why not? You're great in class.
But I'm no Roger.
Come on, you're not upset about that.
Yes, I am. I was this close to leading the class.
Well, maybe you shouldn't have invited me.
Well, maybe you shouldn't have come.
Okay, you two. Cut it out, or so help me, I will turn this hot tub right around and we'll go home.
Fine. Show off.
Baby.
The only thing saving my reputation is half the guys in the office think I'm nailing her.
Pig.
Prude.
Am I doing something wrong? I mean, do I just not get it? I mean, all I did was take Tuesday out for an innocent cup of gelato.
Oh, Corey, what is it?
Creamy Italian ice cream.
No, I mean, what happened?
I was talking to Tuesday about our relationship, and she flipped out and left.
Relationship? How did I stay 23 and you turn 50?
Just wondering where Tuesday and I were going.
Huh?
Who cares? You know what? I'm not sure this is going to work. I mean, do I really want to be in a relationship with someone who can't talk about the fact that they're in a relationship?
Did you just say relationship like 100 times?
You know, I'm just going to pull way back.
Good idea. Mauled by the tiger once, shame on the tiger. Mm-hmm. Mauled by the tiger twice, you're a moron.
See, I'm not sure that's how it goes.
Oh, that's how it goes. Now move, you're blocking my jet.
Roger blocks everybody's jet. Roger! Venus is working. Do you want to sit on my stool? It's closer to Venus.
Katie, you knew when you invited me to that class you were taking a risk. I mean, I got the moves and you don't got the notion.
This is not the first time you've done this to me, Roger.
What are you talking about?
Junior high talent show. I was flawlessly lip-syncing to Minnie Riperton, and you just had to come out there with those platform shoes and giant glasses.
I had the better act. Besides, look who's talking. Remember when you bedazzled your jean jacket and everybody loved it? That was my idea.
But it was my bedazzler.
I'm not going to dignify that with an answer.
Front of the line was mine, Roger.
Hey! It's my 2-star pupils. You know, nothing does my heart as good as when a friend brings another friend to class and lets them glitter in the glow that is Venus. It's Cavassier, and he's wearing a turtleneck. Makes him look like Billy Dee.
I shouldn't let aerobics come between us. It's already ruined so many other people's lives.
You're right, Katie. I'm sorry, I won't go back.
Thanks, Roger. You shouldn't.
I'm doing a different class on Wednesdays.
That's great. You found your own class.
Actually, I'm teaching it.
Ooh, bad news. The chick I was going to take to the Bob Marley Festival canceled. Stuck with an extra ticket.
Hey. What are you doing this weekend?
That's Tuesday.
Really?
Okay, why don't you just come with us without a date?
No way. Roger is not about being a third wheel. Tuesday, you know anybody? She doesn't know anybody.
What do you mean I don't know anybody? I know people.
No, I know. I just haven't met a lot of your friends. Or any.
Roger, I'll set you up.
Cool. Then we're on.
Oh, Tuesday. Make sure the lady doesn't have wax wings, because, she's going to be flying dangerously close to the sun.
Okay, we're done. Here you go, Daddy. Fried chicken and mashed potatoes. It's Owen's favorite.
Dig in. We got a motto in the Navy. Take all you want, but eat all you take.
Roger has a motto, too. Chicks don't dance with a fat guy.
Now, let's take Roger.
Finally.
Would you rather look at pictures of a fitness apparatus or a bevy of sweaty, glistening women in form-fitting lycra as they work their way to firmer thighs and rock-hard buns?
Thighs and buns, please.
And say this wasn't just a 30-second commercial, but ran 10 minutes late at night. And these sensual women share their success stories with you. Would you buy this product, Roger?
Sure.
Do you know what this product is?
No.
Do you care?
No.
Marty. Sign here.
You bet.
Just out of curiosity, what am I buying?
It's the Butt Luge 2, completely repackaged for Christmas.
Still don't care. You ready?
Hey, which look do you like better? Hot?
Hotter.
Hotter?
Hotter.
I'd go with hotter.
Yeah, me too.
Well, boys, I'm off to supervise my first informational commercial. How do I look?
Like a distinguished older man who's about to drop a bundle on a young lady in a leotard.
Good, then I'm good.
Hey, why aren't you dressed? We're supposed to pick up the ladies in half an hour.
This is what I'm wearing.
I don't think so. You are bringing down our collective fashion quotient.
Oh, no! Not our CFQ!
Hey, so what do you know about my blind date?
Well, I know that she's the first friend of Tuesdays I've ever met.
Ooh, you can learn a lot about a person by their choice of friends.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, look at us.
What happened to you?
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 Dad gone?
Yeah, he just left.
Darn. I just worked up the nerve to tell him that I dropped out of college.
No, you didn't.
You're right. I've been hiding in my room in a shame spiral. Oh, God, I have to tell him.
Break his heart? All he wants is one of his children to be a business major.
He's still not over Corey's humanities degree.
Philosophy, with a minor in music. Either way, you majored in poverty. Archie is a little upset by that.
How would you know?
We dialogue.
This is killing me.
Hey, look. Just go down to the school and tell him the truth. You'll feel better.
But what if I tell him and he drifts from bar to bar, drinking and looking for answers?
He does that now.
Right. I'll tell him. Corey, you better get changed. You're going to be late for your date.
Is that her?
No.
Is that her?
No.
Is that her?
No.
Then why is she coming over to the car?
Oh, wait, that is her. Hey, Patty.
Hi.
Hey.
Hi.
Patty, this is Corey.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Hi.
And that's Roger.
And I'm better than you expected, am I right?
We'll see. Roger, what do you do?
Oh, direct. I like that. I'm in the automobile industry.
Not bad. I'm in finance. I love money.
You may love money, but I'm in love with money.
Nice work.
Just call me Cupid. Do you rent or own?
Lease to buy. Oceanside view.
Oh, rent controlled on the beach, utilities included.
Nicely done.
Mm-hmm. I'm a certified scuba diver.
Who isn't?
I once had to hold my breath for 2 minutes before I could resurface.
2 minutes? For amateurs.
Oh, yeah? Let's see. What are you doing?
They're really holding their breath back there?
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't think it was possible, but you actually found someone that matches Roger's maturity.
I have a system.
Hey, what do you say we go to the club and get a drink before the concert? Rog, you in?
Honey, isn't it nice when the kids are quiet?
Damn, I'm out.
All right, you win. You win. Ready?
I went to Berkeley.
I went to Stanford. Graduated in 3 years.
I finished in 2, which was totally unprecedented, but I did go in with 14 advanced placement credits.
I had 17.
Okay. Well, really, I had 19, but
But since Berkeley didn't offer historical languages, my medieval Spanish credit was totally wasted.
Totally wasted. Good idea.
What's another round?
Oh, I'll buy.
No, I'll buy.
Okay, fine.
Did I win that one?
I don't think so.
What is with that woman? Is it me or is she overly competitive?
Ooh, yeah. Hey, but good job not sinking to her level.
Thanks. Hey, what else am I good at?
Why don't you just ask her to dance?
That's it. Dance is Roger's ultimate weapon. At home court advantage. I will destroy her on the dance floor.
Hey, care to dance?
You might not want that.
I want that.
What's with your friend?
I don't know.
I mean, is she usually like this?
Beats me. I've never been out with her. She works my bank.
I don't think you can handle it.
Oh, you're just saying that because you can't handle it.
Oh, watch me. Roger, where the hell have you been with my car?
Where haven't I been with your car? If you know what I mean.
So it worked out with your date?
Yeah, it worked out a couple of times. If you know what I mean.
We all know what you mean.
I don't know what he means.
Roger, you got something that you didn't expect, and you just went with it and had a great time. Imagine that.
What's that on your arm?
Oh, this. AAA had to saw through your steering wheel.
You have insurance, right?
Yes, I do.
Give me a wrist. I know how to do this.
Hey, thanks. Man, I need coffee.
Yeah, coffee sounds good.
And fries.
Well, sure, that's easy. You dress like you're washing the car.
Morning, where's the coffee?
There's no coffee. Let's go.
Right now?
Hello, I haven't done my hair.
You'll have to do it in the car.
Without coffee?
There's no coffee!
Sorry, Roger. Katie's kind of falling down on the job.
And who gets hurt?
You. If you don't come now, I'm leaving.
Do.
What are you doing? Crimping my hair. That's portable.
Yeah, you can take it camping.
Gotta put a little more hump in the hump day.
You know, some people do that in the bathroom.
I would have if you hadn't rushed me out the door. See, my friend, looks are everything in this business.
Business of being Roger.
It's an all-day, every-day kind of job.
By the way, you still owe me for that tie.
I couldn't carry a wallet. Jordash was hugging Major ass.
Hey, watch it! Easy driver? See, that she almost hit me.
She's putting on makeup.
Ozone. Smell.
Work like this?
Roger, you look fine. No one's even gonna notice.
Wow, nice do, Michael Jackson. Makes me want a Pepsi.
That's it. I'm calling it sick. I need a really good excuse.
Nobody ever questions mono.
Ooh, mono, the kissing disease. Sexy. You know, I'd pick a disease that people would actually believe that you could get, like, mumps or gingivitis. I'll keep the mono. Bro, I have to get this hair home. Can I borrow your car?
Hey.
E.T. phone home.
What are you doing home?
I didn't go to work. Can't be seen. I'm a horrible mutant.
Roger, you gotta get over this. It's not the end of the world.
Why do bad things happen to people with good hair?
What you need is a couple of stiff drinks.
I'm already there.
Well, then you need some dinner. Come on. Something smells good in the kitchen. Ah, yes, Monte Cristo sandwiches. Yes, indeed, my favorite. They are good. Where are they?
Sophia and I each made one for ourselves.
You didn't make one for anybody else?
Nope.
It's my hair, isn't it? Oh, hey, kids, don't feed the mutant. He'll never go away. Oh, food's too good for Freak Boy.
Gosh, I'm hungry.
You know, I'm not going to eat this. Yes, you are. You're going to eat every bite.
Okay, fine. You know, those shoulder pads you ladies wear, they give you a full sense of power. Come on, Roger. You and I will make something.
Like what?
Something! I'm making sure that every dish in this kitchen is dirty.
Why?
Because I know Katie, that's why. She won't be able to stand it. First she'll wash just one, you know, for herself. Then she'll do a few more. And then before you know it, the whole kitchen is clean. It is a slippery slope, my friend.
Ketchup on the floor.
Good! This is war!
Daddy? Roger?
Katie? Shopping for just one again, I see.
So we agree on sharing chores. That's how it goes.
Fine. Oh, by the way, we're completely out of clean dishes. So I guess you'll have to do a few. You know, just for yourself.
I don't think so. They're paper plates, and they're all mine.
Well, so much for your little evil plan.
At least I still have all my own hair.
Okay, item 120, coffee.
I don't make coffee.
Okay with me, I drink tea. All right, Katie makes the coffee, RT buys the coffee.
Fine, but she has to let me know when we're running low.
And that includes filters.
Okay, we've made the coffee. Now, cleaning the coffee maker.
I'm not cleaning the coffee maker.
I'll clean it.
And if she finds it not cleaned in the morning, she doesn't have to make it.
Deal.
Hey, fabric softener.
I'm not waiting for the rinse cycle.
Okay, Corey does the laundry.
Yeah, that's good.
Hey, Roger, give me a hand.
I can't, I'm setting my swatches. Hey, what time is it in London?
2100 hours. Nine.
These are gonna look real good at the club this weekend.
Oh, I'm not gonna be at the club. I'm gonna be in Hollywood. Corey and Katie are gonna be on Star Search.
What? No one told me.
Well, then this is incredibly awkward.
Oh, and give me a hand here.
Yeah, gladly.
Are you going to Star Search?
No, I'm stuck here. I have to be out of my boyfriend's condo. Apparently his wife wants to use it.
So you knew about Star Search?
Of course. Katie called me immediately. It's all very exciting. Can we move on now?
I can't believe my ex didn't show up for that wedding. Here I bring Sophia, this hot piece of tail.
RT!
Sorry, sophisticated piece of tail.
How'd they get on Star Search?
My cousin Ted, he's a talent scout for the show.
Well, I guess I'll get unpacked. You do have cable in the guest room, right?
Cable, yes. There is a cable in there.
Worry, why didn't you tell me? I can help you. There is no end to the magic that is Roger, and I'm willing to share it.
What are you talking about?
Star Search. It's to the top from here, buddy. You could be the next Jason Winters.
Who's Jason Winters?
4-time champion.
Look, Roger, I didn't tell you because I'm not doing it. And why would I want to be on Star Search singing a stupid cover when I write my own music?
$2,500? Let's see, 10% is $250. That's my fee. Oh, my God, if you win the 100,000,
Roger, you're not my agent.
We have a verbal.
Corey, we are so blessed. We get to be on national TV doing what we love, and we're getting paid.
This is Star Search, damn it!
Excuse my language.
All I'm saying, Corey, is there is big money in brother-sister acts. The Carpenters, Donnie and Marie, Steve and Edie,
they're married.
Oh, that's just wrong.
Hey, I just came by to drop off the itinerary. You need to be in L.A. by 2, because they want to do a costume fitting and interview before the show.
Will it be Ed McMahon?
His assistant. She's pretty. Little mustache. I shouldn't be telling you guys this, but always play to the judges.
Oh, he's right. It's all about seducing the judges. That's how I won Miss Teen San Diego, Miss Coppertone, and Miss Preteen Tijuana.
You won Miss Preteen Tijuana?
Sí, soy linda.
Look, it's not about the judges. It's about the moves. Corey, I think you should open with something like eyes to the left, kick it to the right. Then, oh, reverse, and hip, and hip, and hip.
You need to see that again?
No.
Animal, vegetable, or mineral?
Animal.
Is it fish sticks?
Animal person.
Is it me?
Yes.
Why can't I ride up front?
Because I'd rather have Tuesday's hand on my leg while I'm driving.
She can reach you from the back seat.
And I can reach you from the front seat. Shut up!
Are we there yet?
We just got on the freeway. We've got at least another hour.
Corey, you know what we should do? Donate the $2,500 to the Dolphin Rescue Fund.
I'm at sea. I see dolphins all day. They're really fine. We could use that money to buy a house, a car, a nice barbecue.
What, are you nuts? After taxes, you're lucky if you can buy a good leather coat.
I don't know where you shop.
Man, I'd get my amp fixed and get some studio time, cut a demo.
I go to Paris and take cooking classes.
Cooking classes?
Did I say cooking classes? I meant, I go to Paris and hawk loogies off the Eiffel Tower. Well, if the dolphins didn't really need the money, I would buy a really expensive pair of jeans and finally go to Hershey, Pennsylvania.
Hershey, Pennsylvania? That's the chocolate capital of the world. She's always wanted to go there. You got a problem with that?
Yes. Morons, you take the money and put it in the bank. You buy a new suit, you start lunching at the Harvard Club at a table next to a Fortune 500 CEO, develop a relationship, marry his daughter. It kills him. You take over the company and you're sitting pretty on his yacht, ignoring your friends from high school who didn't let you sit in the front seat.
Okay, Roger, you can sit in the front seat.
Really?
No! Oh, my God.
Very shiny.
Looking good.
I need to talk to Corey alone.
Excuse me, but if you need to talk to my client, I need to be present. Oh, there's Ed McMahon. How's my breath? We're talking ballpark here. $100,000?
No.
$250,000?
No.
Half a mil?
I'm not going to tell you how much I make.
I'll tell you how much I make. What do you drive at?
Hey, who are you?
Someone you need to know. Do you have representation, Ed?
Security!
Oh, security! You don't need...
Ed, hey, Ed.
You're next, Amy. Good luck, honey.
Oh, please, Ed, give me a minute. Huh? Watch this.
Wow, that's dynamite. Get out there, kid. That's show business. Hey, baby.
In your face, you 8-year-old no talent.
I just don't know what I'm going to do.
Owen, I'm going to be here, and we're going to figure it out together.
What happened?
Owen just found out it's the last season of MASH.
I'm taking the rest of the coffee. Patty's upstairs, and she won't drink instant.
Roger, Daddy hasn't even had his yet. If you take that to your girlfriend, I'm going to have to make more.
Okay. Weren't you wearing that yesterday?
Isn't that a girl's robe?
I stayed at Tuesdays. I haven't had time to change.
Oh, so what's your place like?
Oh, it's great. That's really cool. It's this old loft with high ceilings. It's really raw, with exposed brick, exposed everything. It's a pit, Roger. I hate it.
Why do you stay there all the time?
Because Tuesday's there.
Patty only wants to sleep at my place. Problem is there's no sleeping, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
No, I don't think you do.
Yeah, I do.
No, you don't.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Hey, Corey.
Patty?
Oh, coffee yummers. Okay, come on now, Roger. I got about a half hour before I got to be at work. You know how it is, Corey.
No, I don't.
Anybody who'll make me flapjacks gets a tenner.
Hey, RT. I want to introduce you to my girlfriend. This is Patty.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
Is there coffee?
Hey, I'll still get a tenner if I make you toast.
You tired?
In your dreams.
Good, because I got big plans for you later.
See that? Nothing but Patty's boy toy. All she wants me for is sex.
That's not true. There's dancing.
That's foreplay. You know, sometimes she shows up at the car dealership in the middle of the day in one of her crazy disguises, demanding I take her for a test drive.
Roger, you shouldn't let a girl use you. You have so much to offer.
Thea? Is that you?
Good night, fellas. God bless.
She's a mess.
Yeah.
It's kind of refreshing. Sophia's right. I'm gonna tell Patty there's more to me than just sex. Oh, look at her. Waving at me to come into the ladies' room with her. We haven't done it in there yet. It's kind of hot.
Hey, RT.
Hey, Roger. Miss? Well, good night, everyone.
Let's go, Roger.
Patty, can we sit for a second and talk?
We talked in the car. Come on, move it.
Have either of you seen Patty?
No.
No.
Have you seen Tuesday?
No. No. What about Katie?
No.
Oh, my God, they've evacuated the women.
With all that racket, somebody better be cooking. Well, I'm very disappointed.
All the women are gone.
Well, we should call the police.
Owen, relax, will you? I've been around women long enough to know that if one disappears, you got a problem. But if they're all gone, it's a midnight shoe sale.
I can't believe they're not back yet.
I'm thinking maybe I should come clean with Roger about what happened between me and his girlfriend.
Dad, you've never taken the high road before. Why start now? Besides, she probably doesn't remember.
That'd be a blow. I don't know. Maybe you're right.
Shh. Do you hear any corn popping?
No.
Damn. That was the last one.
This is my fault. Katie was so mad at me, she probably decided to run away from home.
What did you microwave, a tire?
I can't believe Tuesday just gets up and bolts. Well, what, is she trying to make some sort of point? Oh, our little household doesn't suit her. No, she'd rather live like a squatter. That somehow makes her happy. Well, you know what? She has insulted the entire family.
Whatever. You know, this isn't so bad once you get past the grit.
I gotta tell you, I'm sort of enjoying this break from Patty. I'm not just on this planet to service her. I've got ideas to share, wisdom to impart.
What should I do about Katie?
I don't know, man. I got my own problems. What am I supposed to do, huh? Live in a dump and drink out of bug candles the rest of my life? You know what I'm gonna tell her tomorrow at work? Done. Forget it. It's over. Because if she rejects my family, she rejects me. What is this, Godfather 3?
Katie, I'm so sorry.
Move over and I'll forgive you.
Where have you guys been?
We had to go help out Sophia. Did you know she has a sister that's a troll? Let's go upstairs.
Oh, no.
To sleep.
Really?
Just sleep.
Okay, I'll let you off the hook this time. Roger. Why aren't you sleeping on your own couch?
I can't. I just armor-alled it.
Listen, let me ask you something. Tuesday's roommate skipped out on her, so she needs a new roommate. And I was thinking maybe I would move in. What do you think?
Oh, ho, 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 my friend.
Could you be more specific, Santa Claus?
You don't want to do that?
Okay, how come?
Well, you're missing a step. You went from basic math to calculus. Now, where's the algebra, baby?
I don't know.
You need to do these things in increments. When Patty started staying over, she got a hook in the closet. And after a few weeks, I gave her part of a shelf. Someday, maybe I'll let her use the bathroom.
All right, so you're saying slow down. Okay, yeah, I see your point, surprisingly.
Come on, face it. It's your rush. You got it made here. Fridge is full, cable's free. The beauty part is your best friend lives 15 feet away.
Good point. Oh, and about that, if you could close your window when Patty's over. No offense, I just can't stand to hear another fake orgasm.
Yeah, I am pretty loud, huh?
No, I really mean it this time. I'm gonna move into Tuesday's place.
What?
You...
Aramis. Well done, RT.
Hey, you're gonna move into Tuesday's? We talked about this. We decided we weren't ready.
We changed our mind.
I just remember, son, when you live with a woman, she's going to come home and want to tell you how her day was.
Every day.
Are you saying that you and Tuesday are that serious that you're willing to give up our dream of a two-bedroom on the marina with a wet bar and remote control drapes?
Yes, we're serious. We've talked. Well, I've talked, and she doesn't leave the room anymore. And for her, that's huge.
I don't believe this. Why did I steal that welcome to Sizzler sign if this wasn't going to happen?
Look, Tuesday needs a roommate, and it just seems right.
You know what seems right to me? Hating you.
Well, that's very mature.
Are you saying you're more mature than me?
Well then, Señor Maturioso.
Be sure to pack that box of Hot Wheels you have in your closet.
Dude,
oh, yeah! I saw them. Why are we doing this at night?
Here's a good reason, because Katie wants to.
Okay, people. Bring back an empty beer can. Get a full one.
Okay, no, you're right. This is a good thing to do, right? Yeah, okay. I'll tell you what. Tuesday and I'll take this section over here. Katie, you and Owen go down over there, and Roger and Patty will take the area near the highway.
Great. We'll meet back here in an hour. Let's go.
That I'm sitting over there, not helping Katie, pretending he's not thinking about me.
Roger, so he's moving in with Tuesday. I am sorry you're disappointed, but friends move on. You haven't said anything about my hair.
I like your hair.
Can't help it if it's been overshadowed by deceit and betrayal.
Roger, I'm sorry, man, but hey, think about it. Hey, wouldn't you rather have that great place we dreamed about all to yourself so you could rub it in my face?
To be honest, in my fantasy, I never really saw you there. You just paid half the rent. Hey, good luck, man.
Yeah, this is a great night. Two more jello shots.
Hey, I found a football. Go along, Roger. Hey, keep going. Go!
Are you okay?
Oh, my God. I was this close to death. Every outfit I've ever worn flashed before my eyes. You saved my life.
You threw up in my mouth a little bit.
Yeah, you're hot.
I know.